your EP, The Voice of Savannah State University. Tonight we're going to interview Kenya Cabine from 93.1. Let's get in and get to see what he's doing and get to know what's going on.
Hi, Kenya.
What's up, baby?
How you doing?
What's going on?
Hi. Everything okay?
Yeah, everything's good. How you been?
Fine. I need an update on you.
Dang, just like
that. That's what make it natural.
Right.
You know? So what's been going on?
Oh, everything's been going on. Work is going good. Life is going good. Can't complain. You know, it's good to be here with you up in the ATL. This is my hometown. So, you know, it's good to be back home.
How'd you feel when you know, I told you to come to Atlanta to, like, do the interview? Was you cool with that?
Well, yeah, I'm always cool with coming to the ATL, but in a way, it's kind of bittersweet because it's like, you know, this is the place where I grew up, and, like, coming home hasn't really been the same ever since, you know, my mom was diagnosed with dementia. So, you know, it's like, you know, I could come home to the ATL, but it's not really home because, you know, I'm crashing at friends' cribs and, you know, doing the hotel thing, and that's something that I haven't been used to because, I mean, you know, all my life I've always, you know, come home and stayed with my mom, you know what I'm saying? So it's kind of, you know, it's a different, you know, it's kind of bittersweet to come home and not be able to be at mom's house, get some of mom's cooking, you know, watch TV, sleep in my bedroom, you know what I'm saying? I mean, all of that has completely changed.
When's the last time you seen her?
Yesterday.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, let's get a little bit into this. Sometimes, you know, I ask some questions. It sounds crazy, but I'm pretty sure you never heard these things before. But, you know, my question is this. Your mom is in a home, right?
Yes, well, she's in assisted living. You know, it's like different from a nursing home, but it is an assisted living facility that specializes with people with dementia and Alzheimer's. Go ahead.
Well, let me ask you this. Why is she not living with you in your home?
Well, because I felt like, you know, I could not be able to take care of her like I wanted to. You know, in the beginning, when I first moved my mom down here back in, like, what was that, a couple of years ago, you know, she was staying with me. And, you know, I was having her in, like, an adult daycare and everything. But then, you know, when I go out in the middle of the night, when I have, like, the host parties and stuff like that, I can't watch her. Right. And I can't leave her in the house by herself right. Because she can get up and wander out. That's what people with dementia do.
All right, so I want to touch bases with you with a couple of things that I want to know myself, and I'm pretty sure other people. I want to know some things about the radio station. You know, I like the radio. Right. So there's certain things that I'm going through, and I want you to make me understand this. Right. I want to talk about your mom and different things like that. Now with the radio.
Started from the bottom, now we're here. Started from the bottom, now my whole team here. Started from the bottom, now we're here. Started from the bottom, now the whole team here. Started from the bottom, now we're here. Started from the bottom, now my whole team here.
E93, Savannah's hip-hop and R&B leader, the brand new joint from the homie ASAP Rocky featuring Drake. That joint was called Problems, 2 Chainz on that joint too. Kendrick Lamar, I'm Kenya Cabine, hope you're doing good. It is officially Trifling Tuesday, so I want you to jump on the E-lines right now. Get at your big dog.
How do you feel about when people make you feel like you're supposed to do something for them because they're an artist? I mean, like, I just feel like the Spiritual Detox Show, I do what I want. Like, I mean, who does that? You understand what I'm saying? Like, who are you to tell me what I'm supposed to be doing? And
right.
When I owe you, I have nothing to do. I have
right.
a way of doing things.
Right.
So how do you deal with that when somebody gives you a CD and they get mad at you because you didn't play it?
Well, you know, I make it clear from the jump that, you know, the only thing I could do is pass it on to the mix show host, Mike Fresh, and that's the only time when people don't understand. Like, they think that they could give me a CD and then we could just put it on instantly. It doesn't work like that. You know, E93 is like all radio stations in the country. We're a commercial corporate radio station, and we don't run the independent artists. You know, we only run independent artists during the weekend, and that's just for like an hour on Club 93.1. But any other time, you know, it's just like straight, you know, Alicia Keys, Walk Off Like a Flame, Trinidad James, you know, all day, every day, you know.
I mean, that's the only different thing that we have a difference between you and I.
Uh-huh.
Thank God. You know, now I want you to give me your honest opinion.
Okay.
Okay.
All right.
How do you feel about playing the same song over and over and over? It was one time in my mind, I thought I was bugging out.
Uh-huh.
I'm like, didn't I just hear this song? Is it
right,
me?
Right.
You know, how do you feel about that? I mean, seriously.
How do I feel about it? I mean, I get tired of it, but at the same time, I mean, you know.
What is it about behind the scenes? Is it a money thing?
My, you know, Cumulus Broadcasting, they're cutting checks for me. So, you know,
okay.
You know, I gotta, you know, just.
So it has nothing to do with you guys' choice.
No.
It has something to do with the record companies and the.
It's just a corporate radio station. And basically what happens is, you know, they base that off of like how long people listen to the radio station.
Mm-hmm.
So your average person is listening to the radio probably like about like 45 minutes to 50 minutes a day. That's what they say. But however, you and I both know that there's people that are, you know, working like, you know, 8-hour shifts that are listening to the radio station,
right,
you know, all day long.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, that's what the corporate people, they say, you know, that's when people listen to the station. So,
mm-hmm,
you know, it's just, you know, that constant familiarity that people want, you know,
right.
And when people call and say, okay, you know, we want to make a request, I say, all right, I'm gonna get that song on for you, because 9 times out of 10 EP, that song is gonna eventually come up and
right,
be played, you know what
right,
I'm saying?
Right.
So, you know, that's
90.3 FM, it's your girl EP, Detoxing Through the Wire with Kenya Cabine.
What's up?
You have some pretty teeth. Oh my
Thank
God,
you.
I
was trying to give my, like, you know, big boy sexy look to the camera, so you know.
I know, I'm looking like.
Thank you.
But let me ask you this. Now, I've been going through some struggles now. I need some help.
Okay. Well, I mean, why? I mean, you know.
No, because I got struggles too.
No doubt.
You know, we all have struggles.
Right.
And I know that you've been in the business for a very long time.
Right.
So sometimes I know I'll be coming out of my character. And sometimes we need to talk to people that, you know, they're professional.
Mm-hmm.
They know how to deal with certain things.
Right.
And, you know, I'm a person that I love to learn.
Right.
You know, when you are building a brand,
uh-huh,
King of Bean is your brand.
Right.
The things that hurt us when we're trying to fulfill our destiny is there are people that we're gonna have to let go.
Yeah.
We're gonna have, but this is the hurtful part.
Right.
It's the people you least expect.
Right.
You understand what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And in order to fulfill and head towards your destiny, you have to do what you have to do. It's nothing personal, it's nothing, you know, to get at anybody, but it's just more of, I have to stay around the people that's gonna pull me to where I'm going.
Mm-hmm.
Because nobody's gonna understand that, especially if you don't do what I do.
Right.
You know, gossip, littlest things can hold you back.
Yeah.
You know, how do you deal with your surroundings?
Well, I keep a real close circle of friends.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I keep a close circle of friends. I got, you know, my boo, you know, that I've mm-hmm. been with for.
Oh, y'all didn't get married yet?
No, we didn't get married yet. there you go. We'll talk about that on another show.
I'm gonna talk about that. We'll talk about that at the end of the show. Okay. So tell me about that. Like, go ahead.
Yeah, no, it's just I keep a real good circle. I keep a real good circle of friends around me, and you know, I love them. They're like my brothers and sisters, because I'm like, you know, and I'm an only child, so if I befriend somebody, you know, it's for life, you know what I'm
right,
saying?
Right.
And I really value friendship, I really do.
Let me ask you this also too, this is a very good question, okay?
Mm-hmm.
Do you see yourself being married?
Yeah. No, not soon. I mean, one day. Maybe
okay.
soon.
You said that in the last interview. You said one day. Okay, look. This is what I want to ask.
Uh-oh.
This is a very important question. Because in this industry,
uh-huh,
this is what has a big impact on a lot of celebrities
right,
and people's life.
Okay.
You know, what type of woman is built
for,
to be in this game for you?
Oh, for or just anybody in entertainment or for me? Just
for everybody. Like,
a general answer to that is someone, a woman that's understanding, that's not jealous, you know, because there's times where, you know, a person can come in late from, you know, being out in the clubs, or, you know, I might have to travel and stuff like that. I mean, that comes with, you know, this business, this radio business, you know what I mean? You're always on the go all the time. So, you know, it takes someone that's very secure, someone's very confident in themselves. You know, she's got to be, you know, a very religious person too. Not like, you know, throwing Bibles or anything at me, you know what I'm saying? But, you feel
just
me?
Somebody that has faith in something.
Yeah, somebody that's spiritual.
Wrong, that's gonna keep it together.
Yeah, definitely.
Right,
you gotta,
right,
you
right,
gotta have God in your life.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So that's what it is, you know what I'm saying? But someone that's, you know, definitely at the end of the day, just, you know, a good-hearted person, you know what I'm saying? But someone that's got a good mind and that's very secure, and someone that's not insecure.
Are you scared of marriage?
I think, maybe just a little bit, but not really. Can I just re-answer that question? I don't think so, you know what I'm saying? Because, you know, I love love, you know right, what I'm right, saying? Right. I mean, you know, I'm a loving person.
All right, but here's the thing. Let me spiritual detox you a little bit.
Okay, spiritual
love,
detox.
Life, like, what happened yesterday has happened before. What happens tomorrow is going to happen again.
Right.
And I truly feel like, you know, experiences I teach you, everything we go through in life, just like with your mom and everything like right. that, these are things that's already going to happen. We already told this is going to happen. It's in the Bible.
Right.
People are going to die. Things are going to happen. God says, do not get attached to the things in the world. Right.
Right. right.
You know, you got to live life. You have a purpose. Everybody has a gift.
No doubt. Right.
And I really feel like I can see things you think I don't see with a person.
Oh, so what do you see about me?
No, we'll talk about that later. I'm telling you, I think you're scared. I think you're scared because I feel like you. I don't think that you want your life to change right now. I think you love it. It's peaceful.
Right.
You know, things go a certain way. And everybody knows when it comes to a relationship, it's a commitment.
Yes. I've compromised. She know, I don't want to get into all that.
Right, okay. right. I'm going to get into it. Don't worry about it, girl. But anyway, it's about compromising. We only live once.
Right.
And I feel like when you love somebody and you trust them, regardless, things are going to happen.
Right.
But it's certain things that you can see that you will not tolerate.
Right.
Only thing, see me, I can't tolerate cheating.
I can't tolerate that.
But this is what I realized.
It's all in how, I'm sorry to cut you off, but it's all in like, you know.
You're not sorry to cut me off.
I'm not going to give anybody a reason. I'm not going to give you a reason to, you know, think I'm cheating. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
So everything that I do is very consistent, and I expect the same.
All right. So what you feeling that way, this is how I feel. If a person is cheating regardless of what they're doing, I'm not going to worry about their problems. That's something for you to worry about. Because when you get caught, you already know.
Right.
You understand what I'm saying?
But, kick to the curb.
Right. So basically, it's like, you know, when you're with somebody, you love a person even more being in the industry, because it's like, I don't feel like a little kid.
Mm-hmm.
Like, so where you was at, where you was going, we passed for a stage. Before, we used to like it because it chose.
You used to like that?
You can. Yeah.
Really?
I used to like that because we already care.
Uh-huh.
So, you know, I mean.
Where you going? Where you going?
Exactly, yeah.
Where you at,
girl? After a while, I realized, you say that, I run.
Right.
You know, you're too overprotective or whatever. But I think that you just live one life, and I think that, you know, especially when you love, you can't let your past affect what's going on.
Mm-hmm.
So some people are trapped in their past. Your past is your experience to learn that, you know what? Anytime a person is very impatient with something or they're doing something, they're either going to get worse or they're going to get better.
Mm.
You know, when it gets worse, oh, I'm gone.
Right.
Because you don't want to make somebody change. You don't want to make somebody love you. You understand what I'm saying?
Right.
You want to be in it together.
Yeah.
You know, if sometimes, you know, a person may get mad at you, but like a couple of weeks later, you're like, dang, I see the change though.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
You know, we had a little argument and this and that, but you know, it's just about being confident.
Yeah.
You know, but like you say, you don't go get married tomorrow. You give each other time to grow.
Yeah.
And be friends and, you know, whatever.
I think though, marriage takes time and you really got to get to know somebody.
Right.
And I've seen so many people.
Do you ever know somebody?
I've seen a lot of people that have gotten married, and the reason why I just, you know, I take my time is because I see a lot of people that get married for the wrong reasons. Oh, because, you know, my family says I should be married after a certain age.
Did you see a lot of people have babies?
I mean, I know a lot of people that have had kids and, you know, gotten married, and some people are unhappy, and then there's some people that are loving their marriage. I have a lot of friends that are married, that are happily married, they love one another, and that's a beautiful thing.
You see everybody with their kids, right? You see everybody with their marriage. Guess what?
What?
You ain't never gonna know nothing until you have your own experience and have your own kids.
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely.
So you cannot compare what everybody else is doing and what's going on with them.
Right.
You gotta do what can you to be. Because guess what? I already know there is no doubt. When you have your experience, you're gonna want to talk about it.
Yeah. Oh, absolutely.
You understand what I'm saying?
And I know I'm gonna be a good father.
Yeah.
I love kids.
You're a good son. Why wouldn't you?
I love kids.
You know?
And I know that I'm gonna be a great father.
Okay. So next time I interview you, where we gonna be at? Where you wanna be at?
Next
time we do an interview, we're gonna have you. You know, we're gonna be at a totally different level.
Oh, absolutely. I think I grow every time I talk to you.
Oh.
Yeah.
So maybe we'll be in Jamaica or something.
What, at my wedding?
Yeah, at the wedding. That's a good
idea. I knew
that's
what you were going to say.
That's a good idea. I was heading towards that.
I knew you were.
You saw like Atlanta Housewives. See how you took her on an island and finally took her to how she wanted to get married and all that stuff?
Oh, gosh. You watch TV.
I love it. Why not? It's people.
Oh, no doubt. And it's a beautiful thing. I think marriage is great.
Yeah.
But right now, you know, I'm trying to, like, you know, I have a lot of stuff on my plate right now. But when it's time, it's time.
You'll be the first. Is that excuse?
That's That's not an excuse.
Okay.
But you'll be the first to know, and you'll get the exclusive.
Okay, I will?
Yeah.
Let me in first. Let nobody else in. Okay?
You got it.
90.3 FM. It's your girl, EP, and Kenya Cabine on the Spiritual Detox Show. We had a wonderful time. Enjoy. Peace.